What's going on, everybody? This is Kurt and I'm back with a new video. So today we will discover together how to master Udemy's workflow. On a Art Surface Pro, we will create UVs, and after analyzing the different materials, we'll set up them in Udemy accordingly. Then we will export it to Substance Painter, texturing it quickly, and then get everything back to Maya. So get relaxed, grab a coffee or a cup of tea, and let's roll the intro! So guys, in order to discover the complete Udemy's workflow, we need of course a 3D model. So let's take this great model. If we check the outliner, we've got a main group with inside all the geos with a proper name convention. Okay, then let's analyze a bit this prop. As we can see, there are a lot of objects that are duplicated. So let's unwrap the side part first. Let's open the UV editor. First thing to do is camera-based UV mapping. Then select the edges that we will need to cut. After selecting them, go to UV Toolkit and click on Cut. And then we can do the Unfold. Nice. Let's scale it a bit and rotate it to fit the UV island boundaries. We can check the Unwrap activating the check map in the UV editor. Sweet. Let's repeat the same process for the main crate piece. So, camera based, select edges, cut, unfold. Be cautious where you do your cuts, as it will be noticeable. It's always better to do them in a place that is hidden or not that visible. Repeat the same process for every main object, one of each type. Yes, UV unwrapping is a pretty boring and repetitive step. I will accelerate this part a bit, but as you can see, it's pretty straightforward, not that complicated, but time consuming. As I've said before, there are a lot of duplicate shapes in this prop. So I will use two really useful scripts made by Liam Collod. They are free and the links will be in the description. So thank you mate for this. So the first one is Select Similar. So select a shape, run the script, and it will automatically select all the same meshes in the scene. Pretty cool, right? Then with the second script named UV Transfer, as the name says, it will copy the UVs to all the similar shapes. Really nice. Now just repeat the same method for the other shapes. Boom, now everything is unwrapped. Next, in order to divide all the UVs in multiple UV island UDIMs, it's a good idea to split them by materials. So let's define the different parts by materials. So let's create three materials. One for the crate base, one for the plastic handles, and one for the metal clips. Okay, next step is pretty important. In order to have a UV cohesive proportion on all UVs, we need to select the mesh with the larger UV. Then, under Texel Density, click on Get. Select all the meshes and hit Set. It will apply the same Texel Density on all the UVs. Okay, sweet. Next up, we need to lay out everything in different UV island. So let's open Layout under Modify menu. Let's make sure we have Preserve UV Ratios selected. Texture map size to your texture size, 4K for us. And let's input a shell and tiles padding to have some gaps between UVs. Then let's open the Hypershade and select the first shader. And in the Layout UVs option, click on Apply. Boom, we've got all the UVs port layout properly for this material. Repeat the process for the remaining two shaders. Okay, done. Now everything is overlapping in the first island. That's not what we want. We want to use a UV island for each material. So three UDIMs split by materials. Don't forget to not use negative UV island. Okay, so select the geo assigned to the first material. Then on the UV toolkit panel, search for Transform Move. Change the value of the Move property to 1. Select the UV shell and click on the right arrow to move everything to the second UV island. Next up, do the same process for the second material. Done. Now we've got 3 UDIMs set up for this prop. The advantage to work with UDIMs is that we will have a lot more pixel definition and resolution for this asset. 3 times exactly. Rather than have one 4K texture, we will have 3 4K texture for each shader input. Okay, now that is done, we do not need any more the temporary materials. So let's apply a single shader. Let's name it IE Create. Remember to delete history and freeze transformation. Now we just have to export the model to FBX for Substance Painter.
Hey you, I know you are watching my video and I know you are not subscribed yet. It's literally so easy, just go down there and boom, press subscribe. So like this video, comment and hit the subscribe button.
Okay, so here we are now in Adobe Substance 3D Painter. Go to File, Open. Select the PBR Metallic Roughness Template. Document Resolution to 4K. Normal map format to either DirectX or OpenGL. Then, most important, choose UV Tile Workflow under UDIMS Settings. And finally, Color Management to Legacy. As for this demo, we will not use ACES. In Input Meshes, choose our FBX previously exported. Okay, sweet. We've got our model loaded in, and we can find our UDIMS shown on the texture set list. If we change the view to 3D 2D, we can see our UDIMS in the 2D view. Okay, next step, we have to bake our maps. So go to the texture set settings and click on Bake Mesh Maps. Okay, then on the main window, deactivate ID Mesh Maps. We don't need them. Choose the output size map to 4K. Select this option to bake our eye mesh on itself. And click on Bake Select Textures. Let's process it all. Boom, done. Now we will apply some smart material to go faster and illustrate the whole workflow. I've developed this post-apocalyptic smart material for my Scavengers Refinery project. They are pretty cool and they are available on primalvfx.com. Links in the description. Pretty sweet, right out of the box. Now we want to apply this shader only on the crate. So click on the right square to select the corresponding UDIM. As you can see below, we can select and deselect the UDIM. Nice. Now let's do the same thing for the remaining two UDIMs. Let's apply another smart material and select the desired UDIM. Now the last one. Boom, done. Now it's time to export the maps. I will use my custom presets that comes with my Substance to Painter plugin. It's not mandatory, but it will speed up a lot the workflow. If you are interested to know more about it, check the upper right card. It's also available on primalvfx.com. So let's choose S2M UDIM EXR preset. File type select based in output template and a 4K texture size. Finally, choose a location to export the maps and then hit export. Boom, done. Now we are back to Maya. I've set up a quick scene with lights, backdrop and camera. Normally here you will need to create the shader and plug every map that you've exported. But luckily with S2M plugin it will be done everything for you in few clicks. So launch that plugin by clicking on the icon. Choose EXR, UDIM workflow and advanced shading control. Then click on Create Shader Tree button. Input the shader name that you originally defined and click OK. Boom, done in no time. Everything is already configured and ready to go. Now just select the model and apply the shader to it. Let's launch the IPR to check if everything works. Really, really nice. This is the complete workflow of doing UDIMS for any model on Maya. Export it to Substance Painter and go back to Maya. What do you think, guys? Now you can master the process on your own.
Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the content, you know what to do. Subscribe to my channel for more awesomeness. And I see you guys in the next video.